Hey everyone, I'm Kelsey.
And I'm KK.
I've got a question for you.
Okay.
What was your favorite teardown from 2017?
Man, we do so many teardowns. Let me think. Oh, actually, I really enjoyed the My First Phone, the Teardown video series that we did. I actually got a chance to open up my first cell phone, which was the Sony Ericsson T616, and just so much nostalgia, which was great. How about you? What was your favorite?
I actually liked the Essential phone, so while it wasn't the most repairable phone, I got to bust out the freeze spray and freeze some gummy bears, so that was pretty cool. But today, we're actually here to talk about the most repairable devices from 2017.
You wouldn't think a tablet could be very repairable, but HP proved that wrong with their HP Pro X2 1012 G2, which scored a 9 out of 10 on our repairability scale. With a complete set of repair manuals online, expandable standard storage, modular parts, and no major use of adhesive, this tablet was built with repairability in mind.
You'd hope a laptop would be expandable and repairable, and that's exactly what the Dell Latitude E5270 is. With easily accessible and replaceable RAM, battery and SSD, modular components throughout, an immediately replaceable display, and manufacturer-provided repair documentation, it's no wonder this laptop earned a 10 out of 10 on our repairability scale.
We didn't see a ton of super repairable smartphones this year, but our top scoring phone was the OnePlus 5, which scored a 7 out of 10, just barely nudging out the iPhone 8, 8 Plus, and the Pixel 2 and 2 XL, all of which scored a 6 out of 10. The OnePlus 5 used only non-proprietary screws, a display held in by clips instead of adhesive, and had a ton of modular components, including the cameras and the USB-C headphone jack cable.
When it came to game consoles, it was pretty much good news all around, with the Nintendo Switch and the Xbox One X both scoring an 8 out of 10. The Nintendo Switch made the smart choice of relying on screws instead of adhesive, and using a ton of modular components, including the batteries, which can be replaced by users. The Xbox One X proved to be just as repairable, only requiring a few tools to do a complete disassembly. It had clearly labeled modular design that allowed the drives, fans, power supply, and just about everything to be easily replaced, and with fewer interlocking body panels and a simple clip arrangement, opening the Xbox is easier than ever.
So we love it when companies factor in repairability into their devices, and we hope it's a trend we continue to see next year.
We've got all the links to the teardowns in the description below, so be sure to check those out. Hit that subscribe button, and we'll see you next year.
Bye.